गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो नाइन्थ क्लास, वी आर हेयर अगेन विद चैप्टर नंबर 6, टिश्यूज। सो बिफोर हॉलीडेज वी हैव कंप्लीटेड 2 चैप्टर्स ऑफ बायोलॉजी। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर व्हिच इज आल्सो फ्रॉम द बायोलॉजी, टिश्यू, राइट। सो क्लास, फ्रॉम द लास्ट चैप्टर just recall some terms, right? As in the first paragraph of this chapter, you can see we have all living organisms are made up of cells, right? In unicellular organisms, a single cell perform all basic functions, right? A single cell performs all basic functions. For examples, in amoeba, a single cell carries out movement, intake of food, gaseous exchange, and excretion, right? Whereas in multicellular organisms, there are millions of cells, right? And most of these cells class are specialized to carry out specific functions. In human beings, muscle cells contract and relax to cause movement. Nerve cells carry messages. Blood flows to transport oxygen, food, hormones, and waste material, and so on. Right? In human beings, the role of cells are very wide. And let's talk about now plants. Class, in plants, there are some vascular tissues which conduct food and water from one part of the plant to other parts, right? So multicellular organisms show division of labor. What it show? Division of labor. So from this paragraph, what we have concluded, in human beings, there are millions of cells, right? In human being, there are millions of cells, right? And the function of these cells are very much wide. As I told you, we can say there is a division of labor in multicellular organism. We have given here one example. In human beings, as muscle cell contract and relax, right? Nerve cell, the role of nerve cell is what? It carry messages, right? And one more thing we have, which is what? Blood flow, right? Blood flow, which transport oxygen, food, hormones, and waste materials. Waste materials we are talking about here, CO2. Right, CO2 and urea. So class, in the wider role, we can say here, cells which specialize in a function, we are grouped together and form a tissue, right? Blood, phloem, muscle are all example of tissues. So we can say here, what is tissue? A group of cells similar in structure that work together to perform a particular function, right, forms a tissue. So you can note down this definition also. I will highlight here what we have given. Right? A particular function is carried out by a cluster of cells. Cluster means we are talking about here group, right? At a definite place in the body, and this cluster of cells is known as tissue, right? An example of tissue are what? Blood, phloem, and muscle. Right, class? So, all cells of a tissue have common origin, right? For example, human nervous tissue, I'm just adding here extra point, which is actually present in brain, spinal cord, and nerves, right? Which has nerve cells, or we can say neurons, right? The role of it, it is what? Actually, they are basically same in terms of structure, in terms of function, right? All nerve cells basically have a cell body. What? It has cell body. So let's discuss about here second paragraph, which is, are plants and animals made of same type of tissues? क्या प्लांट और एनिमल्स जो होते हैं वो सेम टाइप ऑफ टिश्यूज के होते हैं क्या? सेम टिश्यूज उसमें यूज होता है, दैट वी हैव टू डिस्कस हियर. सो लेट अस कंपेयर द स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन. डू प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल हैव द सेम स्ट्रक्चर? डू दे बोथ परफॉर्म सिमिलर फंक्शन? दीज आर सम क्वेश्चंस व्हिच वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट, राइट? लाइक हमें यहाँ पे क्या क्या क्वेश्चन दिए गए हैं. क्या प्लांट्स और एनिमल्स का सेम स्ट्रक्चर होता है? एज वी नो दैट इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल, राइट? दे डू नॉट हैव सेम स्ट्रक्चर. कैन दे परफॉर्म सिमिलर फंक्शन? ऑफ कोर्स नॉट. प्लांट्स हैव देयर डिफरेंट फंक्शन एंड एनिमल्स हैव देयर डिफरेंट ड्यूटीज, राइट? सो डेफिनेटली आंसर इज नो. So, just look at here, right side part. There are noticeable differences between the two. Plants are stationary or fixed, right? They do not move. Since they have to be upright, they have a large quantity of supportive tissues. And the supportive tissue generally has dead cells. Class, the questions which we have given under this topic is what? Are they perform same functions? Are they same, right? As I told you, answer is no. But why answer is no? We have here explanation. Plants जो होते हैं वो fixed होते हैं, stationary होते हैं, वो एक जगह से दूसरी जगह move नहीं कर सकते. Same thing we have with animals, right? Animals can use in search of food, shelter, they can move from one place to another place, right? They consume more energy as compared to plants, right? So most of the tissues they contain are living. In animals, that tissues will be living, right? Whereas in plants, supportive tissue will be dead cells, right? Now, I will show. In right side, we have one more thing. Another difference between animals and plants is what? Pattern of growth, right? The pattern of growth will be definitely different in plants as well as in animals. There are some tissues in plants that divide throughout their life. And these tissues are localized in certain regions. And based on the dividing capacity of these tissues, cell growth in animals is more uniform. So we can say here, organization of plant tissue is simple, whereas organization of animal tissue is complex, right? And here one more thing. Tissue organization is meant what? Stationary habit of plants, right? Whereas tissue organization in animal is generally targeted towards high mobility of animals. Now we have here, as I told you, it's complex, right, in animals. This fundamental difference reflects the different mode of life pursued by these two major groups of organisms, particularly in their different feeding methods, right? They are differently adapted for a sedentary existence it means we can say in plants there will be locomotion, whereas in animals, in plants there will not be locomotion. Locomotion means they cannot move from one place to another place, but in animals it totally belong to it, right? So we can say here plants are stationary. As a result from this topic, what we can conclude here, plants are autotrophic. They can prepare their own food, right? They are stationary, they are fixed, they cannot move from one place to another place for the searching of their food, right? So we can say here plants tissue are supportive, which provide them structural strength, jo unko stationary fixed bilkul straight khade hone mein unko help karta hai. Most of these tissues such as xylem, phloem, right, sclerenchyma and cork, these are dead tissues. As I told you, in plants there will be dead cells, right? So they, one more thing, as they are dead tissues, so they will not contain what, living protoplasm, right? On the other hand, in animals, as you know that animals are what, heterotrophic organism. For the searching of food, they have to move from one place to another place. Even for the shelter, they have to move. So they required more energy as compared to plants. And most of the tissues they contain, I am talking about here animals, right? So animals will contain living tissues, right? There are some tissues in plants which divide throughout life, which actually also responsible for the growth and reproduction of the plants, right? So this is about topic 6.1. Now, second topic I have here, plant tissue. Now we have to discuss here about plant tissues. So first we have here meristematic tissue, right? Before going on this tissue, first let's talk about here plant tissue. Plant tissue, we have here two types, meristematic and permanent, right? Permanent plant tissues are of two subtypes, which we can say simple and complex. Meristematic kya hota hai? In this tissue, cells are capable of cell division and have potential, right? And in permanent tissue, we can say mature cells incapable of cell division. So let's talk about here meristematic tissue. As we have given here one activity also, we have given here two jars in which we have onion, right? And here we are talking about the growth of roots, right? This activity I will discuss at the end of the plant tissue. Let's first discuss about this word meristematic. So, what is it? Class, cells of meristems divide continuously, right? Once you will got the concept of meristematic tissue, then you will understand this activity. So, cells of meristems divide continuously and help in increasing the length, right? And help in increasing the length of the plant. Meristematic cells may be spherical, oval, polygonal, or we can say rectangular in shape, right? These cells are compactly arranged so that they cannot, or we can say they do not contain any intercellular space between them. It means first they will be arranged compactly. Compact matlab dono kafi ek dusre ki kafi close hongi ye cells, right? And there will not be space in between them. And it contains dense cytoplasm or a single large nucleus, and these cells contain few vacuoles, or we can say no vacuoles. Some cells definitely will have, or some cells will not. So we can say meristematic tissues are what? These are growth tissues. These are growth tissues and found in the growing regions of the plant. This is the reason we have here this activity. As meristematic tissue is what? Growth tissue. So according to their position in the plant, meristems are apical or lateral. Okay, class. So this is about meristematic tissues. Now, as I have used here two word, apical and lateral meristem. What it is? Class, apical meristem kya hota hai? It brings about the elongation of the root and stem, right? Yahan par jo bhi increment hoga, or we can say increase jo growth hogi, wo kahan hogi? Root or stem ke andar. So we can say the result will be in the height of the plant. So apical meristem is also known as primary growth. And I have used here one more word, which is lateral. Lateral meristem. It causes the organ to increase in diameter. This is called secondary growth, right? For example, cork produces a protective cork on the outside and secondary cortex tissue inside. जो कॉर्क होता है क्या प्रोड्यूस करता है प्रोटेक्टिव कॉर्क आउटसाइड एंड इनसाइड इट प्रोड्यूस कॉर्टेक टिश्यूज सो दिस इज अबाउट लेटरल मेरिस्टेम सो टू वर्ड आई हैव यूज्ड दैट आई हैव कवर्ड नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस एक्टिविटी So this activity is all about growth of roots in onion bulbs. As we have given here two jars, so take two jars and fill them with water. Try to do this activity at home and take two onion bulbs. Onion bulbs means aapko do onion leni hai, right? And place one on each jar. Placement should be like this ki jo mouth hai dono jar ka wo is tarah se hona chahiye. जो स्टेम और रूट के जो पार्ट्स हैं राइट दैट विल बी इनसाइड सो इट मींस व्हाट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट हियर वी हैव टू प्लेस बोथ द अनियंस इन दिस वे सो दैट स्टेम एंड रूट पार्ट्स ऑफ ईच अनियन रिमेन इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद वॉटर राइट आफ्टर दैट यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व द ग्रोथ ऑफ द रूट्स इन बोथ द अनियन बल्ब्स एंड यू हैव टू मेजर द रूट्स at least for the 5 days day 1 day 2 day 3 day 4 day 5 ka aapko isme se record rakhna hai kyon rakhna hai this is given to us actually this is the reason we have to find, we have to take the record of growth of the roots of onion bulbs right after that we have to find out answer of these questions Which of the two onions has longer roots and why? कौन सी onion जो है उसके longer roots हैं और क्या reason रहा? Do the roots continue growing even after we have removed their tips? Why would the tips stop growing in jar 2 after we cut them? So these we have to figure out. I can say I will give you here one answer of first question. Roots of jar are longer actually since they have dividing cells at the root tip right in jar b there will be no growth of roots ask why since they lack the dividing cells right cut root stop growing since there is no dividing tissue present it means if you will cut the root then might be there will be the growth will be stopped right so don't try to cut the root if you will cut the root, then definitely there will be definitely growth will not be there. So class, the growth of plants occurs only in certain specific regions. This is because the dividing tissue, also known as meristematic tissue, which is located only at these points. And depending on the region where they are present, meristematic tissue are classified as apical, lateral, and intercalary. Right? One word we have here, intercalary. What it is? It produces an increase in the length of an organ, such as leaves and internodes. So, jo plants mein jo changes aate hain, growth hoti hai, wo kahan hoti hai? Leaves or internodes par, right? That is intercalary meristem. Now, here we have the word which we have covered here, apical meristem, intercalary, and this is lateral meristem, right? As I told you, apical kya hota hai? Apical root or stem, right? Jo plant ki jo height hoti, or we can say jo increase hoga, wo hoga plant ki height. Jo plant hai, uska size increase hoga. That will be apical meristem. Now let's talk about intercalary meristem. Intercalary stem, you can see in between एक particular organ जो है, right? Organ की length increase होगी, such as leaves or internode. Internode आपके बीच में भी हो सकते हैं, center में भी हो सकते हैं, right? So if there is increment in leaves or internodes, it means there will be intercalary meristem. Now third word we have here, lateral meristem. ये क्या होता है? यहाँ पर जो डायमीटर है स्टेम का वो इंक्रीज होता है. डायमीटर मतलब उसकी मोटाई, उसकी और छोटा हम उसको बोल सकते हैं कि जैसे आपकी जो स्टेम है कितनी मोटी होगी, राइट? पतली होगी कि मोटी होगी, राइट? वो हम डायमीटर के अकॉर्डिंग जज करते हैं. सो इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट हेयर लेटरल, दिस इज द रीजन एट द एंड वी हैव गिवन हेयर लेटरल मेरिस्टेम. यू कैन सी हेयर दिस पार्ट इज वाइडर इन दिस स्टेम, राइट? So here increment in is only diameter. So apical meristem can be found in on what? Stems and roots, which increase the length of the stem and the root, right? And the girth of the stem or root increase due to the lateral meristem. You can do one thing, note down these three words separately, then I will move forward. बेटा जब भी आपकी लेक्चर आप वीडियो लेक्चर देखते हैं, सो यू हैव टू डू वन थिंग, कीप वन नोटबुक विद यू, राइट? एंड वन पेंसिल, सो दैट इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट यू कैन नोट डाउन. सो आई हैव हियर थ्री वर्ड्स. एपिकल मेरिस्टेम, व्हाट इट इज? इट ब्रिंग्स अबाउट द इलोंगेशन ऑफ द रूट एंड स्टेम. इलोंगेशन मीन्स देयर विल बी सम इंक्रीमेंट, राइट? सो write down, it brings about the elongation of the root and stem. It means increase in the height of the plant. It is also known as primary growth. And second word we have here, lateral meristem. What? Lateral meristem. ये क्या करता है? It causes the organ to increase in diameter and girth. This is called secondary growth. थर्ड वी हैव इंटरकैलरी मेरिस्टेम. ये क्या करता है? इट प्रोड्यूस एन इंक्रीज इन द लेंथ ऑफ एन ऑर्गन सच एज लीव्स एंड इंटरनोड्स. सो क्लास, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट मेरिस्मेटिक टिश्यू. सेकेंड टिश्यू वी हैव हियर परमानेंट टिश्यू. सेकेंड पॉइंट वी हैव हियर परमानेंट टिश्यू, दैट आई विल कवर इन माई नेक्स्ट वीडियो.